Students, next we discuss about equations of motion for a freely falling body and vertically projected body. Okay, so first of all you have to write equations of motion in case of first freely falling body okay we have to release an object above the certain height from the ground above the ground is called freely falling object or freely falling body. So this is moves under gravity acceleration and this acceleration remains constant. So this is uniform acceleration, that is earth provide uniform acceleration due to gravity. So that's why we have to write these equations of motion. So first of all, first equations of motion. First of all, we consider an object is freely fall from certain height and it reaches to the ground and its initial velocity u0, its final velocity v equal to v and its acceleration is plus g and its traveling height above the height is s equal to h. That is this distance traveled by the object, maximum height is h. Okay, now the students, we write the equations of motion for this one. So we know that the equations of motion, what are they? First one, v equal to u plus at. So write v is v, substitute u 0 plus at, a is g and time is t. That is, what is this time? This time is total time taken by the body to travel maximum height to ground position. Okay. So this one v equal to gt. Okay. And this implies this t equal to is v by g. By using this formula, we have to find time of descent of the object. What is time of descent? The time taken by a body to travel from maximum height to ground, is called time of descent. Now, in this one also, we have to represent v is proportional to t. Similarly, and we have to take second equations of motion. What is the second equations of motion? The second equations of motion is s equal to ut plus half at square. Now we have to write this s is h, u becomes 0, this term is 0 and remaining half a is g, remaining t square. This is height. By using this formula, we have to find height. H equal to half gt square. And in this also, we have to write H is proportional to t square. Okay, students. And next, we discuss about third equations of motion. What is third equations of motion? Is v square minus u square equal to 2as. Okay, so v square minus u becomes 0 and 2a is g, s is h. So v square equal to 2gh or v equal to root of 2gh. By using this formula, we have to find final velocity of the object. And in this one, v is equal to root of 2gh. And v is proportional to root h. So velocity, final velocity is directly proportional to square root of the height of the object. Now in this one we have to also find maximum height. Okay, so this maximum height is h equal to v square by 2g. So by using this formula we have to find also maximum height of the object. Okay, this is freely falling object equations of motion. Now next we discuss about second one, vertically projected body. For this one we have to write equations of motion. Okay, now in this situation this is the vertically projected body and it throw with velocity, initial velocity u, and its final velocity v becomes 0, and acceleration equal to is negative of g, and the distance, that is maximum height traveled by the object, is h. Okay, now we have to write the equations of motion. So first one, first equations of motion is v equal to u plus at, which is equal to u, v becomes 0, u is u, a is minus g. So this implies v is 0, u, a is minus g into t. Okay, so that's why u equal to gt, this implies t equal to u by g. This is time taken by the body to reach maximum height from the ground is called time of ascent. Time of ascent formula is t equal to u by g. Okay, now the second equations of motion, s equal to ut plus half at square. This s equal to h, u equal to u, minus half a is minus g into t square. Okay, so this is h equal to ut minus half gt square for vertically projected body. By using this one we have to find height. And the third one, that is v square minus u square equal to 2as. In this one v is becomes 0 minus u square 2a, a is minus g, s equal to h. Okay, now we have to write this u square equal to 2gh, because of negative, negative becomes cancel. Now in this one u equal to root 2gh, or simply said h equal to u square by 2g. Okay, so in this also we have to see this v u is proportional to root h also. Okay, so we compare in both equations of motion, third one, in both sides what happened, the final velocity v equal to root 2 gh and the body projected initial velocity u equal to root 2 gh. That's why a body is projected upward with velocity u and it reaches to maximum height and again it returns to the earth. Then what happened? Its initial velocity is equal to final velocity. Its initial velocity equal to final velocity. So that's why we have to write the velocity, projected velocity and upcoming velocity is find out by using this one, v equal to root 2 gh or u equal to root 2 gh. Okay, and in this situation what is the total displacement of the object? In this situation total displacement of the object s becomes 0 because of it is initial point and it is also same point, final point. So displacement becomes 0, but distance is s and also S. So totally 2S. Okay. So these are the very important formulas in our objective purpose. Okay.